In this video, I'm going to show you biodigester mistakes you must avoid when you are constructing a simple on-site biodegradable biodigester. I'm Jerry, biodigester constructor, consultant with 8 years of experience in the biodigester construction business. On this channel, I do videos that explain to you how biodigesters work and how you can use them as an option in managing your dream house. When it comes to biodigester construction, there are problems. And the problems are usually associated with mistakes that is not making your biodigester work effectively for you. This can lead to homeowners not being happy with the type of digester you have constructed for them, and then actually saying that biodigesters do not work. In this video, I'm going to show you probably the mistakes that you are making in your biodigester construction shed. Let's go into the video now. The first mistake on my list for this video is the fact that you are probably not doing a proper site assessment before constructing your biodigester. That can lead to a lot of complications for your biodigester construction journey. You cannot construct a biodigester on a hill and expect the pipes to be run into it smoothly. You need gradient, one, two, you need a slope. Another mistake you are also making in your biodigester construction journey is not asking the homeowner the right kind of questions.
The number of toilet seats that you have in the house, where the project is located, it's good to have a background knowledge of what exactly you are going to meet when you show up on somebody's project or somebody's site. It's good to ask the right question before you come to your conclusion whether this is a digester or this is a project that you can take on.
Not constructing the right size and type of biodigester for the property you are working on is also another mistake you are making in your biodigester construction journey. When it comes to biodigester construction, each property and facility you are working on must have a particular type of biodigester you are going to construct for it. It could be a standard family size, it could be a large family size, it can be a commercial digester, depending on what you meet site. So the next time you are constructing your biodigester, make sure you are constructing the right type for the right type of facility. The fourth biggest biodigester construction mistake you are making is not doing an effective and proper soakaway for your biodigester.
You need to consider the users and the lifestyle of the people who are going to use the facility to ensure that it's deeper than the digester bed and has enough slope to let out the black water from the digester bed.
If the homeowner is willing to invest in a soakaway, then obviously everybody's problem is solved. You have done the block work, you have left some holes at the base. So let's say the water doesn't go, you have put a clean out on top of the slab. So in a worst case scenario, and the water is not seeping away, it's not going, you will just open it up and have that water pumped. Any excess water in the biodigester will immediately run back, do the soak away, and then that can all go, so that your biodigester works well for you. So any issue, you open the soak away, you take the water out, the biodigester is back to its use.
Now, most of the time, sudden, whenever I see it, and it is the fact that biodigester constructors are adding the kitchen waistlines to their biodigester soakaway.
The reason why biodigesters work is because we separate the water from the human waste. So by adding the kitchen or the bathroom wastewater to it, you are virtually rendering the digester from working to its full capacity.
Adding the kitchen wastewater and the bathroom to the biodigester soakaway is a big no-no. Another biodigester construction mistake you must avoid is to put a vent pipe and a biodigester. Biodigesters are simply on-site biodegradable toilet waste management system. They really work well when it's sealed and it's airtight. The biodigester does not need a vent to let in any air. They work in the absence of oxygen. Why on earth would you go and put a vent cap or a vent just to let the air out? You are not constructing a holding tank, which is a septic tank, whereby there's a lot of heat in the tank because the water becomes hot with time. Your construction is simply based on the fact that you let the water out through a system, and the biodegradation happens when the digester is sealed watertight. So the next time you're constructing a biodigester, avoid this particular mistake. On this channel, we do videos that explains to you how to construct a biodigester, and for homeowners who want to use the technology as a means of managing all their human waste. If this is your first time on the channel, go ahead and subscribe and be part of a growing community of biodigester lovers. The next biodigester construction mistake
you must avoid was not putting in the right biodigester construction bedding material. The right bedding material is key to your biodigester construction success. Anytime you construct a biodigester, make sure you are using the right material. This biodigester construction mistake is a controversial one. You are probably not charging the right price. Yes, for your biodigester construction, you are probably not charging the right price. For each type of biodigester you construct for a particular facility, the cost that comes with it is what you must look out for. It's best to be transparent with the homeowner or your clients about the actual cost of the digester than to be just looking for something to survive, because things are hard and we are naturally not making any biodigester sales. So the best thing to do is to charge the right price whenever you do that, the biodigester construction contract. The next time you are constructing a biodigester and you are deciding to put it in the gutter or in a drainage system, make sure you do an enhanced filtration for the biodigester. And that's the next mistake you are making if this is not what you are doing. Whenever you construct a biodigester and you are giving a direct line into a gutter, you need to do enhanced filtration, which means you need to do an additional soak away that will retain the water before the clean one goes into the gutter. Toilet water is not allowed in gutters in Ghana. You do need a certification to do that, just to avoid all the problems that comes with such a situation. Whenever you construct a biodigester for a gutter, make sure you add an enhanced filtration to it. This biodigester construction mistake saved me and my clients thousands of Ghana cedis. And that is trying to replace a septic tank with a biodigester without meeting key conditions. Whenever you do get a business, a client comes up to you and say, I have a septic system or a manhole, it's not working. I want it replaced. Is there something you can do about it? There are certain key conditions that you must meet if you can really replace it with a biodigester. It's key for you as a biodigester constructor to know the key conditions that you must meet if you want to replace a septic system with a biodigester.